Subscribe to Mind Body Soul and click on the bell icon for more updates.
On a typical day at my clinic, around 60% of my clients report that they feel constipated on a very, very regular basis. But do you know what's even more unfortunate? It is that we're so shy and embarrassed to discuss about this topic openly, which leads to many, many misconceptions around the same. For example, don't we all feel that only by eating the correct food and by making the correct food decisions, we can prevent constipation and it'll never happen to us? But did you know that even beyond food, there are several other factors that can lead to constipation? What are they? Let's find out today. Hi everyone, I'm Srishti Vasandani. I'm a certified holistic health coach and a lifestyle and wellness expert. And today we're going to talk about all the causes of constipation. Now, can you imagine what happens when we're constipated? We start holding on to all the toxic wastes inside our body rather than being able to eliminate it, and this is the beginning of a disease. So today let's understand some of the common mistakes that we make on a daily basis that can actually lead to constipation to occur for many of us. Number one, when it comes to food, eating a very low fiber diet and consuming very little water during the day, these are the two major contributors to constipation at the most basic level. Number two, we are all eating more and more out of packets. Now, this means eating more of the processed foods, which are very high in salt and rich and dense in refined sugars, making them very difficult to digest for our bodies. Number three, lack of movement, or leading an inactive or a largely sedentary lifestyle. Now, what this does is that this does not even allow your food to quickly reach the colon. Coming to sleep. Now, with sleep, number one, inadequate sleep. Number two, sleeping at odd hours. Number three, a disturbed sleep. And number four, sleeping in a state where our minds aren't really switched off disrupts our entire digestive system, because the body cannot clean itself in the wee hours of the night where the liver and kidney should have been performing the function of cleaning. Next, stress. Now, when it comes to stress, I want you to know that our gut is also called our second brain. So fear, worry, anxiety, or any other negative emotion that we might be facing upsets the gut function completely. A few secondary causes which might also lead to constipation can be like delay in going to the bathroom when need be or when you feel the pressure to. Now, when you do this, your body actually gets trained to ignore that signal every single time. Number two, travel. Number three, a shift in your working hours, which upsets the entire rhythm of your body. And also a few medications like antacids and laxative abuse. So now that we've understood all of these causes that might lead to constipation, we need to figure out as individuals which of these holds true to us. In my next episode of The Health Space, we're going to be sharing my top powerful natural remedies to cure your constipation naturally. Until then, stay healthy, stay happy, and stay tuned to your very own The Health Space.